Good morning, everyone. My topic is limb and deficiency after rolling normal fractures in pediatric age group. Limb and deficiency means it is a difference in the load both the limbs due to after the, it could be congenital, but my topic is after limb and deficiency, it's a difference in the both the limbs length. There are two types of growth in the bone, epiphyseal bone growth and positional bone growth. Epiphyseal bone growth is contributed by the epiphyseal plate and positional bone growth is contributed by the periosteal osteoblast. And this one is transient, another one is longitudinal cell growth. Factors increasing local vascularity increases the rate of cell multiplication, resulting in weathering. Example, trauma, infection, hematoma, and AD malformation. So, minor limb deficiency due to asymmetry between right and left limbs are common. Deficiency of 2 cm have been observed commonly in children. This shortening is compensated by pelvic tilt and is not clinically significant. Allergy that occur after healing of fracture results from excessive overriding of the fracture and fragment or excessive distraction. Angulation can also result in allergy. When reduction is just right there, there is tendency of the fractured limb to overgrow. Overgrowth of 1 cm is expected irrespective of the sort of treatment, either open reduction or close reduction or conservative. This is because of increased blood supply to the healing bone, which increases the linear growth of the bone. And overgrowth is a universal phenomenon which is independent of the age and level of the fracture and the time of healing. The first 15 months after the fracture are the most significant period of growth. Overriding up to 1.5 cm is acceptable irrespective between acceptable in children between 2 to 10 years old, showing which is the greatest, they are showing the greatest tendency of overgrowth. In children less than 2 years of age, the overgrowth is less significant because the period it is 3 weeks that the period of stimulation for growth is minimal. A little about girdling or debarking phenomenon, this which is practiced in horticulture, elevation of the bark of the trees to increase productivity is being practiced. The same principle applies where at the time of fracture healing in the bone, and periosteum gets elevated during operation, during plating procedure. The aims of my study are to determine the limb length discrepancy after lower limb normal fracture in 2 to 16 years, to determine the effect of allergy or the activities of the patient. My study is a hospital-based retrospective study done at Princess Asura Hospital and Obesity Hospital Research Center. The methodology which I use were preoperative x-rays, immediate post-operative x-rays with alignment measurement. Follow x-rays to remodeling occurs, manual measurement of the allergy by two observers. The limb length discrepancy was measured from the anterior superior iliac spine to the medial malleolus with midpoint and medial joint line in pelvic squat position. CT scanogram was done if the allergy was more than 2 cm. The patients which are included in my study are all diaphyseal fractures, femur and tibia with or without fibula, age group of 2 years to 16 years, operated in our hospital or in other hospital. Managed by any means open reduction or close reduction or conservative. All the pathological fractures and fractures in the open fractures in bone loss excluded from the study. So the patient's ages were ranging from 3 years to 16 years with a mean of 8.5 years and 45% patients were having positive deviation for weight for age. And 35% has negative deviation, 20% patients were having ideal weight for age. The BMI was ranging from 9 to 20 kg per meter square with a mean of 13.6. Male predominance was observed in 65% patients and 45% female patients. 14 patients reported to the orthopedic surgeon immediately after the injury and 6 patients had native treatment in bone setters and came and reported lately. 40% tibia fractures were reported and 60% femur fractures and 55% right-sided fractures and left-sided 45% patients. The fractures were at the level of metaphysis in 7 patients comprising 35% and diaphyseal fractures were comprising 65%. Conservative management was done in 7 cases with 35% comprising 35% and remaining surgically operated patients with close reduction internal incision with TENS and external fixated application comprising 25% and open reduction was done in 40% patients. No overriding was found in patients operated by open reduction in 8 cases and close reduction in 3 cases, overriding less than 1 cm in 4 cases and 1 to 2 cm overriding in 5 cases with conservative management. LLD measure was ranging from minus 1 cm to plus 3 cm with a mean of plus 1. Shortening was observed in 2 cases and no LLD in 3 cases, less than 1 cm in 10 cases, less than more than 1 cm was found in 5 cases and 2 patients complained of limping which were operated for drill epiphysiolysis, one for femur and another for tibia. So here the discussion is, fractures though look little override and monolinear x-rays in pediatric age groups can be managed conservatively. It may be a concern for the parent, but proper counseling of the orthopedic surgeon will help. Later application of removal of stimulus periosteum need to be avoided as much as possible. Elastic nail and external fixators are implicated from my study. LRD is an expected complication after the fracture of the tibia or femur. Patients need to be informed about it. It's more common when the fracture is complete without overriding and fixed with a plate. The patient needs to be monitored for the symptoms, and if any epiphysiotesis of the limb to stop further growth at appropriate time in skeletal maturity when physis is about to close to solve the problem. Thank you.
Your study included only diaphyseal fractures?
No, sir. Diaphyseal and metaphyseal and epiphyseal fractures are not included.
In your slides, I have seen only diaphyseal fractures you mentioned, no metaphyseal fractures.
I included both.
Okay. 35% metaphyseal. Only lower limb injuries are.
Yes,
you included only lower limb fractures, not upper limb.
Yes, sir. Lower limb fractures.
Not
upper
limb.
No.
Why?
Because lower limb is, because they are more complicated, upper limb it will almost get compensated, sir, in the upper limb, and lower limb also gets compensated, but it leads to more complications.
In which fractures you notice more limb length discrepancies, the metafacial or diaphyseal fractures?
Sir, in diaphyseal fractures, because they were operated mostly by plating procedures, sir.
Forget about operation. If both managed conservatively, which fracture is more prone for developing limb length disturbance, whether metafacial or diaphyseal fracture?
Metafacial, sir.
Why?
Because of the blood supply is more in the...
Good. Blood supply is more rich in the metafacial fracture, so the limb length disturbance will be more when that part of the bone is affected.